I made so much money selling Buzz's potatoes. I ought to do something for him. He still needs that bezel for his radio. Let's see here. Dial escutcheon. He's so dumb, he didn't even know you could order these. I just need the phone number now. All I have to do is call the Stromberg Carlson Telephone Manufacturing Company in Rochester, New York. I'll just call the operator and get information. Hello? Is this the operator?
This is the operator.
This is Dickel of Flocket.
Yes, sir. May I help you?
I would like to place a call to the Stromberg Carlson Company in Rochester, New York.
Stromberg Carlson?
Yes, Stromberg Carlson.
I have no listing under that name.
Huh? What? You don't have a listing?
No, sir.
Come on. They gotta be there. It's a big company. They make radios.
There's a Carla Stromberg Carlson.
There's a what? A Carla Stromberg Carlson.
Yes, sir.
Well, connect me to that. Maybe they can help me.
Hello, this is Carla Stromberg Carlson speaking.
Hello, Stromberg Carlson?
Yes.
I would like to order an escutcheon for a 1939 Stromberg Carlson model 430H.
What's that escutcheon thingy you're talking about?
What's an escutcheon? It's like a decorative frame.
I have a decorative frame. Why don't you come up and see me sometime, big boy?
What?
Well, welcome to part 6 of the Stromberg Carlson Restore.
Go screw yourself.
How you all are today?
I'm glad for you to see me, I guarantee.
What you're looking at here is the bottom of the chassis, of course. And this is where the screw that you put from the bottom of the cabinet through. And it screws this here and it secures the chassis to the cabinet. As you can see, this grommet here is toast.
I'll have some toasted white bread, please.
And I took off one. You're looking at the two tabs.
You don't say.
That I had to bend out to get that bracket out. As you can see, when you bend this, you crack the paint and some of it flakes off. Now this grommet here is one piece, and the larger diameter here goes right here. And what they did was they pushed a smaller diameter, which is on this side, they pushed it through the hole. All right, then they added this piece.
You're touching my piece, Kansas.
Put on a washer. Put this in some type of a punch press or something and flatten this end so it wouldn't come loose. And they attached it like this. Now, I don't know how to replace that. I don't know how I would do that. I could grind this down.
Maybe, but I doubt it.
Put in the appropriate rubber grommets, or grommet. And then take some type of a hard metal and try to...
Hit it.
And try to make a...
flange.
A little thing like this. Smash it down a little bit, but... I really don't know if that would work. And I really don't know if I want to do that.
Well, Lottie frickin' God!
Now, the purpose of this grommet here, I figured out, is to isolate this part and the screw that goes in it from the chassis. Why they would do that, I don't know. since the bottom of the cabinet's wood. Maybe they didn't want anybody to touch the screw.
Huh?
And then maybe some other metal part on there and get a shock. Who knows?
Who knows anything?
So I've got a couple of options. I can leave this as it is to rot away.
Oh, brother!
I could try, like I said, to get a grommet or a couple of grommets.
Look at this idiot.
After I grind this down, stick it in there and hammer that back down like that.
What do you think of it?
But I don't know if I want to do that. So I'm going to leave this up to you guys. I want you to send me your suggestions. If this is your radio, what would you do? What would you do in Buzz's place?
I'd kill myself.
It consists of three pieces. The main bracket, this washer, and this one here that goes through the grommet. With this flange hammered down, punch pressed in. So, I don't know what to do with it.
Me neither.
If I get any suggestions from you guys, I would appreciate it. I'll give screen credit to anybody who comes up with a good idea. Something that old Buzz can understand, because, you know, I'm not too bright.
It's true, very true.
So, come on guys, put on your thinking caps. Okay, I'm gonna replace this whole veneer up here. This has actually got two layers. It's got the nice veneer and it's got this underneath layer here. As you can see.
It's not going to be easy.
I like to take both off as possible, but I don't know. It's gonna work. I'm gonna try heating it up and see what happens.
No. Please, not that. Yes, that.
As you can see, it's not going to be easy to get off.
The enterprise in which I'm about to embark on is fraught with imminent peril.
Cut, free Tanya!
That's bubbling up there.
That's a hot one.
Oh, well, that's hard work.
Looks like I'll have to take a hammer to it.
Clark, what do you need a hammer for?
And, like, chisel it off.
Oh, that's the ticket, sir.
Or I could just cut it here, leave that side on there, and just redo this, and then level it out, and then put a new strip all the way across.
Why didn't you ever marry?
I was in love with a beautiful blonde going stairs. She drove me to drink. That's the one thing I'm indebted to her for.
Now you're cooking with gas.
Well, I'm going to work on this off camera and see how long it takes me.
Well, the sound didn't record, so I'm going to have to narrate this. There it is. It took about 45 minutes. And then I decided that, I might as well go ahead and take that other portion off too. So there I am, using the chisel and the putty knife, trying to take it off.
Okay, I got it done. Took about another hour. So I just didn't want to come off.
What a catastrophe!
Took a little bit of some of the other wood here, but I'm going to fill that in with some wood putty. But I thought I'd just start fresh. I'll put a big thick piece of veneer on here, and then I'll get a walnut veneer and put that on here. Not bad. Babaloo. Babaloo.
Looks like this has come separated. I'm gonna have to glue that.
Always sand with the grain of the wood.
Had lots of dings in it, so I decided just to fill in all the dings.
Marvelous! Wonderful! Amazing!
It's very hot today. It's about 100 degrees.
Hot work!
Damn hot work.
Yikes.
I'd like to stroke it.
Well, it's gonna take a while, so I'll come back and show you what it looks like. Now, this part's okay. I need a little bit more in here and here. Man, it's just too hot to be doing this work. I wished I had a watermelon. I wished I had a watermelon.
I wished I had a watermelon.
Wow, a watermelon. Man, did that look good.
That looks delicious.
Ice cold, too.
May I have some?
No.
I like it a lot.
Oh, man. Old Buzz is going to take a watermelon break. Well, I come back the next day and find this completely separated right here.
Huh?
I wonder if that happened when I was clamping this. This came up, because I didn't notice it at the time. But I'm going to have to glue this area here. Let that drip down in there.
You're soft. You're sloppy. You're unruly. You're undisciplined. And look at the rest of your appearance. You're a disgrace to the outfit.
You gonna clamp him, buddy?
It was a young man from Trent whose tallywhacker was so long that it bent. To save him the trouble, he stuck it in double, and instead of coming, he went.
Looks like it came up from here now, too, so.
Suffering sciatica.
What are you gonna do?
I don't know.
Today I'm gonna paint the transformer here. I was just gonna hand paint it with a brush, but I decided just to take the screws off and see what I get here. We'll take a look at what's underneath this shell here. Oh, it looks in pretty good condition, I would say. So I'll go ahead and spray paint this. I'll have to remember the number goes on the outside. And of course, there won't be a number if I paint it out there. Duh.
Oh, brother.
I guess it doesn't matter, huh? Alright, well, I'll probably paint this edge part by hand here. I'll just put some flat black here.
It's been 84 years, and I can still smell the fresh paint.
All right, let's take a closer look here at the push buttons here.
Okay.
I've got it in the push button mode, and I've programmed these coils here. So let's see what we got here. That's this one here. I guess I got two of the program at the same station. Now that's a push button radio. Doesn't have this nonsense where you push the thing in and this thing moves like that RCA. If they were going to make push buttons, this is the way you would have wanted it. Well, I would have designed it like this.
Ready for your push button finger exercises?
I like it. Okay, there's the speaker we wired. I think it looks pretty neat. I use different colors.
Wow, wow.
I kind of wove it in like a braid here. I put a tie wrapper on here so they won't tug on them.
You done good, Hasselhoff.
Oh, that looks pretty nice. I'm proud of that. Now, if you look up here, I've got the shield back in place. And so we're going to hook the speaker up and we're going to test it and see if it works. Well, there we are. I'm going to turn it on and let's see what happens.
It'll take a minute to warm up.
Sometimes that speaker kind of just pops on like that. I don't know if that's normal, or but everything seems to work all right on it. And this last one is the phono push button. But I think those push buttons work pretty good. I ordered an iTube since this one is so weak. Oh, I guess next is I'm going to put the veneer on. Then I'm going to do some flocking, and then we'll do that in the next episode if I have time. But anyway, I'm very happy so far. There's the painted transformer looking all spiffy.
Oops.
So, it's coming along pretty good.
$24 million.
Until next time, this is Buzz.